Hello everyone, this is the lecture series of hydraulic machine subject and course code of this subject is ME317. This is unit number 5th and lecture number is 36 and this is the last lecture of this series is here. And today I will discuss about the topic regarding hydraulic accumulator and coupling. For my introduction, myself Rahul Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Suresh Gyan Vihar University, Jaipur. For the case of hydraulic accumulator, so hydraulic accumulator is a one device which stores the energy for emergency purpose, which stores the energy for the emergency purposes, and this is a very important device for the case of hydraulic lines. Suppose in any hydraulic systems, sometimes it will fail, sometime it will, or it can be fail. So at that time, fail means pump not working properly. At that time, pump is not working properly. For this case, hydraulic accumulator perform the role of this pump. So hydraulic accumulator used in hydraulic fluid lines and hydraulic type of hydraulic circuits, and these are used for the emergency purpose only. And next topic is here today is hydraulic coupling. So hydraulic coupling, this is a power transmission source and which transfer the power from one shaft to another shaft without use of gear arrangement. This is sometime called the torque converter, because it converts the torque from one end to any other end. So this is the case of the hydraulic accumulator or hydraulic coupling. So for this, objectives of this topic is here. These are the different types of objectives. So by the end of this section, you should be able to understand about this Pascal's law, because all units related to the hydraulic circuit work on the principle of Pascal's law. So Pascal's law states that the intensity of pressure in a static fluid is transmitted equally in all directions. If area is different, if the piston area is different, so if two piston are connected in this series, one is bigger diameter and another one is small diameter. So bigger diameter piston cylinder is called the master cylinder and the small diameter cylinder is called the sleeve cylinder. So this machine is a greater provide the greater versatility ability to adopt. Here are the few examples of the machine are hydraulic circuit, hydraulic line, hydraulic fluid lines are usually the different kind of devices. In the case of hydraulic accumulator, for the case of the hydraulic accumulator, so hydraulic accumulator, it is a device used for storing energy of the liquid, in the form of pressure energy, and which may be supplied for any sudden or increment requirement, intermittent requirement. Suppose a sudden pump failure or some system malfunction, or some valve is leakage, and some set of valve is not properly closed. So at that time, this hydraulic accumulator provide the energy, means it provide the pressurization inside the fluid line. And the, in the hydraulic lift, the main example of this or main application of this hydraulic accumulator, where it is it used, these are hydraulic lift or hydraulic crane. A large amount of energy is required when lift or crane is moved upward, when the lift or crane is moved upward. At the time of extending position, this is the extreme extending position, and at the time pump is not working. So this device means crane directly goes down suddenly. So it restores the energy by the accumulator. It gives the energy and pump this crane. Just it shift the slowly come into the original position, and this energy supplied from the hydraulic accumulator, right? And when the lift is moving in the upward direction, no large external energy is required, and at that time the energy from the pump is stored in the accumulator, right? So the construction of the accumulator construction is based on the construction of the accumulator. This is based on the, it consists of a, suppose here this is the inlet from the pump. This is the inlet from the pump and this is the outlet. So at this case, this is the sliding ram, and first the hydraulic fluid or hydraulic oil is stored inside this chamber, and creates a pressure on the sliding ram, and then sliding ram moves up. At that time weight W, which is attached at the upper portion of the sliding ram, this is directly gives the force at the downside. And in this case, any chances of failure, so this weight just gives the presses the fluid in the downward direction and provide the energy in the hydraulic circuit. And here you seen in this slide, just right here, hydraulic accumulator consists of a fixed vertical cylinder consists of a fixed vertical cylinder containing a sliding ram, and the heavy weight is placed on the ram. And the inlet of the cylinder is connected to the pump, which continuously supply water under pressure to the cylinder, and outlet of the cylinder is connected to the machine, which may be lift or crane or any other device. This is depend on your choice, right? So working of this ram is here. At the initial position, the ram is at the lower position in the beginning. So the pump supplies water under pressure continuously. If the water under pressure is not required by the machine, the water pressure will be stored in the cylinder, right? At that time, any failure of the system or any other chances it will occur, at that time it just provide the pressure, and this will raise the ram on which the heavy weight is placed. And suppose here one heavy weight is placed, and this weight always pushes the sliding ram at the downside. In this case, weight is attached, and this always create the force at the downward side, but this is fluid. Here one fluid which always pushes this at the upward side. So one balance is established here, right? So for the case of when RAM is the upper extreme position, when the RAM is upper extreme position, the cylinder is full of water and the accumulator has stored the maximum amount of pressure energy at that time. If RAM is maximum upper position at that time, accumulator is stored the maximum amount of pressure energy. When the machine requires large amount of energy, the hydraulic accumulator will supply this energy and the RAM will move in the downward direction, and the RAM will move in the downward direction, right? So this is the one formula which find the capacity of hydraulic accumulator, which find the capacity of the hydraulic accumulator. So it is defined as the maximum amount of hydraulic energy stored in a accumulator. It is defined as the maximum amount of energy, hydraulic energy stored in a accumulator, and this expression for the capacity of accumulator is obtained as A is the area of sliding RAM, L is the stroke or lift of the RAM, and P is the intensity of water pressure supplied by the pump, and W is the weight placed on the RAM, and one is W, capital W is here, intensity of pressure, area of RAM. So already you know the work done is lifting RAM, just like the W into lift of the RAM, weight of this component. This is the weight. So this is the capacity of the for the capacity of the accumulator. Only you search this formula. The work done in lifting the RAM. This is the W into lift of the RAM into W by L. This is equal to P into L into A. This is a P into L into A. So therefore, the capacity of the accumulator is equal to the work done in the lifting the RAM. Work done in lifting the RAM. For this purpose, it is given by P into A into L is here. So the capacity of the accumulator is it is equal to P into volume of the accumulator. So here A into L, area into length. L is the length of the accumulator. And this is described by this type of length. Here is this length of the stroke. It means the length, it means stroke length of this piston, right? So this is the length of this accumulator, means sliding RAM length. And area is the cross-sectional area of this sliding RAM, right? So the capacity of the accumulator is equal to the P is the pressure. How much pressure is applied at the downside? How much pressure is applied at the downside? And in the volume of the accumulator. So A into L equal to volume. A into L equal to volume, right? So these are the different kinds of application regarding this accumulator case. So accumulators are used in the energy producing plants. These are the energy power plants, and energy is the topic of the future and the global energy. So where is any hydraulic circuit is required? So accumulator are present. Global energy demand is rapidly rising because of this energy demands. In some cases, and China made a very big dam. China made a very big dam, and America is also, but India, in India, some geographical region is not good. So here, not a big dam, but some small, small dam are present, but in the area of the Kerala and Karnataka in between, a big dam is constructed. So in present time, India goes, send the project to the Bhutan. In Bhutan, three regions in the inside the Bhutan, three regions dams are constructed with the help of India, and this dam producing some electricity. This electricity Bhutan sent to the India also, right? And these accumulator used in plastic machinery also. So in plastic machinery, some molding process are required. In plastic machinery, molding process are required. At that time, some electricity goes down or any pump is not working. So at that time, accumulator gives the energy for this plastic machinery application and the quick response application. Quick response for means some malfunction in the hydraulic circuit, then quick response, it gives the quick response. And die casting machinery, die casting means some die casting methods and some high pressure and flows in a short time period, high pressure and flows in a short time period. And some steel in the industry require this type of accumulator. And some high pressure and fast movement machinery, which required the accumulator, right? So the use of accumulator is very vast in the field of the industry. So we go to the differential hydraulic accumulator. So the differential hydraulic accumulator so, for the case of the differential hydraulic accumulator, so it is a device in which the liquid is stored at high pressure by a comparatively small load on the ram. So, it consists of a fixed vertical cylinder of a small diameter. The fixed vertical cylinder is surrounded by closely fitting brass bushes, which is surrounded by the by an inverted moving cylinder having circular project collar at the base on which weight was placed. So this is the figure of the differential hydraulic accumulator. Suppose in this device the liquid is stored at the high pressure by a comparatively small load on the ram. But this is the for the construction, just you see here, this is the load and this is the moving cylinder, and here is some fixed vertical cylinder, this is the fixed cylinder, and this is the inlet section, this is the valve, and this is the brass bush which connect the this stationary and the moving cylinder also. And one is here fixed vertical cylinder outlet, it goes to the machine also. So it consists of a fixed vertical cylinder of a small diameter, and the fixed vertical cylinder is surrounded by closely fitting brass bush, and which is surrounded by an inverted moving cylinder having circular projected collar at the base on which weight are placed, on which weight are placed here. And for this purpose, if I'm going to the working of this differential accumulator, so the working of a differential hydraulic accumulator. So for the working of this, the liquid from the pump is supplied to a vertical, fixed vertical cylinder, and the liquid moves up through the small diameter of fixed vertical cylinder and then enters the inverted cylinder also. And the water exert an upward pressure force on the internal annular area of the inverted moving cylinder, and which is loaded at the base. And the internal annular or the inverted moving cylinder is equal to the selection area of the brass bush. So it depends on the selection area of the brass. So if brass bush area is more, then it provide the more stroke length, and if it's less, then it provide the less stroke length. And for the case of the when the inverted moving cylinder moves up, means this cylinder is moves up position, right? This moves up position, it shows the pressure is stored, means it means the it is stored the hydraulic energy is stored in the accumulator. So it is stored the hydraulic energy inside this, and at the time of malfunction or any other unit, other classes in this system, it provide the energy at that time. Provide the energy at that time. For the case of calculation, just you move here, P is the intensity of pressure of liquid supplied by the pump. P is the intensity of pressure of liquid supplied by the pump, and A is the area of the brass bush, and L is the vertical lift of the moving cylinder, and W is total weight placed on the moving cylinder, and W equal to P into A. This means P is the pressure and A is the area. So if the P equal to W by A is here, from this equation it is clear that pressure intensity can be increased by making the small area small, right? If area is small, then pressure intensity is large. If area is large, then pressure intensity is less, because pressure intensity inversely proportional to the area, right? So now the total energy stored in the accumulator, this is equal to total weight into vertical lift. Total weight into the vertical lift. So energy stored in the accumulator, this is equal to W into L, right? And sometimes in your competition exam, ask some question. What is energy stored by the accumulator? So the how much energy is stored inside this accumulator? This is given, only formula is here, W into L. And sometimes it will ask the question just like as a capacity of, what is the capacity of the accumulator? Then you give the take the formula from this here. Capacity of the accumulator is equal to P into volume of the accumulator, A in, right? So these are the two formulas are very important. Then comes to the next section of this chapter. This is the hydraulic coupling, and it may be sometime called the fluid coupling also. For the case of hydraulic coupling and the fluid coupling, both are the same thing, or it may be sometimes called the torque converter, because here torque is converted without moving any parts, without touching any parts. Here the torque is, or power is transferred by the medium of fluid, and this type of torque converter or fluid coupling are just you see inside this Volvo type of buses, and this is used for the clutching purpose in trucks and buses and all other types of machine where the gearing arrangement is not required. And एडवांटेज ऑफ दिस कपलिंग, इट प्रोवाइड ए वन एक्सिस पावर विद इन ए शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस, विद इन ए शॉर्ट डिस्टेंस, राइट? सो द टॉर्क कन्वर्टर इज द फॉर्म ऑफ ए फ्लूइड कपलिंग यूज टू ट्रांसमिट पावर फ्रॉम द इंजन टू द इनपुट शाफ्ट ऑफ द ट्रांसमिशन. सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ टॉर्क कन्वर्टर इट रिड्यूसेस द वाइब्रेशन ऑफ द स्प्रिंग, वाइब्रेशन ऑफ द इंजन, एंड इट कैन नॉट ट्रांसफर द वाइब्रेशन फ्रॉम द इंजन टू द अदर बॉडी, राइट? सो बिकॉज ऑफ दिस फ्लूइड कपलिंग इट रिड्यूसेस द वाइब्रेशन ऑफ द इंजन एंड टॉर्क कन्वर्टर यूज फ्लूइड. फ्लूइड इज मीन्स द हाइड्रोलिक फ्लूइड और ऑयल टू हाइड्रोलिकली कनेक्ट द फ्लाई व्हील ऑफ द इंजन टू द इनपुट शाफ्ट ऑफ द ट्रांसमिशन. सो अनलेस द मशीन इज इक्विप्ड विद ए लॉक क्लच, देयर इज ए नो डायरेक्ट कनेक्शन बिटवीन द इंजन एंड द ट्रांसमिशन, जस्ट द फ्लूइड ड्राइव मैकेनिज्म, राइट? सो दीज आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मैकेनिज्म हियर. सो दिस टॉर्क कन्वर्टर जस्ट लाइक इज वर्किंग एज ए वर्किंग फ्रॉम द न्यूटन्स सेकंड लॉ आर एक्शन एंड रिएक्शन लॉस ऑल्सो, एंड द ऑपरेशन ऑफ द फ्लूइड कपलिंग कैन बी कंपेयर टू द एक्शन ऑफ द टू इलेक्ट्रिक पंप्स. हियर इन योर सी इन योर फिगर जस्ट टू इलेक्ट्रिक पंप्स आर गिवन, जस्ट टू इलेक्ट्रिक पंप्स आर गिवन इन साइड दिस फिगर. सो इन दिस फिगर इफ वन फैन इज रोटेटिंग एट वेरी हाई स्पीड एंड एट द अंदर फैन इज जस्ट इज पुट स्टेशनरी, सो आफ्टर सम टाइम इट विल ऑल्सो रोटेट एट दिस स्पीड एंड नॉट सेम एट द फर्स्ट फैन, बट दिस कैन रोटेट एट द सिमिलर स्पीड, कंपेरेटिवली सिमिलर स्पीड, लाइक राइट? एंड इन दिस केस इफ वन फैन इज रनिंग द एनर्जी ऑफ द मूविंग एयर विल कॉज द अदर फैन टू टर्न. And in the fluid coupling, the fluid acts like as the air between the two fans, right? Between the two fans. As with the fans, the output of the fluid power of the driving component act as a input power for the driven component. Input power of the driven component. So for this purpose, these are the two components for the fluid coupling. One is stator and another one is rotor and one is stator component. So this figure illustrates the two halves of the fluid coupling. Here fluid coupling is divided into two parts, and for this two parts a number of straight radial blades extended from the side inside to the outside edge. Inside to the outside edge means the blades are present this section to hub to tip also, right? And the blades in the part on the right side are the part of the housing, and this part of the called the impeller or pump. Impeller or pump, and the blade is not a part of the left side or part of the turbine. So the impeller changes mechanical power from the engine to the fluid power. And the turbine changes fluid power back to the mechanical power to drive the transmission. For this case, the impeller and the turbine are mounted very close together for efficiency. Very close together for the efficiency. Just so this is a one systematic representation of the fluid coupling. The next figure, inside this figure, this shows the systematic diagram of this fluid coupling, and inside this the pump impeller shaft shows the red portion. The pump impeller shaft shows the red portion, which connects to the engine. Suppose this red portion, this is the red portion connect to the engine shaft, and this is called the driven shaft, right? And the second shaft, which is called the output shaft, this is represented by a blue end. This is represented by a blue end, which this is input shaft is called the driver shaft, and the output shaft is called the driven shaft, and which is connected to the driven unit, right? And the impeller and turbine both turn in the housing, and they are not directly connected together in any way. The housing is filled with oil. So all are thing here. So in between, which space is present here, which is filled by one hydraulic fluid, right? And in next, for the working of this, when the engine is started, the impeller start turning. As the impeller turns, it throws oil from the center towards the outside engine, and the shape of the impeller and the centrifugal force move the oil outwards and across into the turbine. So the oil strikes the turbine blades here. These are the blades are present. Then if this unit rotates very high speed, right? So it can send the oil from in the circular motion, and this circular motion create a force inside this unit, in blue type of unit. So it will also gets rotates at the same speed, and the energy of the moving oil is absorbed by the turbine and start the turbine turning. As the oil strikes the turbine, the oil slows down and fluid inward toward the center to re-enter the impeller. At that some time, when the oil leaves the turbine, it is flowing in the direction of opposite to the oil flow in the impeller and tend to the oppose the impeller. The heavier arrow inside this impeller represent oil increasing speed, and the energy as it moves through the impeller. So the small arrow inside this impeller, represent this small arrow, and inside this impeller represent oil slowing down and losing its energy to the turbine, right? So for the case, this type of looks like as a one type of spherical case, right? Just like as a pipe. So for this pipe case, so the figure illustrates the two basic kind of oil flow in the fluid coupling. One is the, this is the circular motion of the object of the fluid coupling, and second flow is this circular motion, right? Means radial direction of this shaft here. So two basic kind of oil flow in the fluid coupling, and rotary flow and vertex flow, and for the small arrows. So the rotary flow occurs when the oil is traveling with both the impeller and the turbine in the direction of rotation. And this happens when the impeller and the turbine are traveling at nearly the same speed. For examples, when the machine is coasting, or when it is being eroded, the oil is sown in outward by the centrifugal force in both the impeller and turbine. Small arrows like this, and turbine round and around, large arrows, right? And at the same at that time, both units are gets rotated. Both units gets rotated at the same speed without any create the vibration, noise, and here and it does not produce any friction. And here, no metal assembly, gear type of assembly are used to transmit the power, right? So it creates a one type of screw type of rotation like this, right? It creates a screw type of rotation like this. So this is a spiral rotation, right? But this is goes through the throughout the radial length, right? And this spiral type of rotation is called the vertex oil flow, occurs when the oil is traveling outward through the impeller across to the turbine and inward through the turbine back to the impeller. The impeller is turning with the engine and the turbine is stalled or held stationary by a load. For this case, oil is traveling across and striking the turbine blades limits oil movement in the direction of the rotation with the impeller. The oil flow path looks like a spiral, right? Spiral. So this is the working of the fluid coupling. Then comes to the torque converter. For this case of torque converter, a torque converter is a fluid coupling with an addition of a stator. And like a fluid coupling, the torque converter couples the engine to the transmission and transmit the power required to move the machine. Right? So this is the one 3D view of the torque converter. And just you see in your slide, this is a torque converter, or this is a real picture. And the unlike the fluid coupling, the torque converter can also multiply torque from the engine, which increases the torque to the transmission. For this purpose, here uses the different types of gearing assembly. So some case of one ring gear or sand gear are present for different types of speeds. So torque converter uses a stator which redirects fluid back into the impeller in the direction of rotation. The force of oil from the stator increases the amount of torque transferred from the impeller to the turbine, creating torque, and this and multiplication for this case. So these are the some component of the torque converter. For this component, just first is one, second and third, three main component of the torque converter. So the, in the first term is here, this is the impeller. First component is here, impeller. And the rotating housing and the impeller turns with the engine, which turns provide the turns by the engine also. And the turbine two, second component is the turbine turns the output shaft, and this turns the output shaft. Here red assembly is shown, which is connected to the driven shaft, and which is connected to the driver shaft. And the second unit is here, blue unit. This is the second turbine, which is connected to the driven shaft. And third is the stator. The stator is a fixed and held stationary by a torque converter housing. So these are the fixed blades, right? and the oil flows for this case in upward from the rotating impeller inside of the housing and downward past the turbine. So from the turbine, oil is redirected back to the impeller by the stator. For this purpose, stator redirects oil to the impeller. So the stator is a stationary part. Suppose in the case of stator, stator redirects oil to impeller. So stator is a stationary reaction member with vanes that multiply force by redirecting fluid flow from the turbine back to the impeller. The purpose of the stator is to change the direction of the flow of oil between the turbine and the impeller here, right? So the direction of the shown of the fluid, just you saw in this figure. So the stator is connected to the torque converter housing, and this is known as the reaction turbine, right? And here the blue part is the driven member of the torque converter with vanes, and the red part shows the driver member of this part. And then here oil flows continuously. This is the stator redirect the impeller, and torque divider. Here there is some torque divider is used. This is the sun gear, and these are the some ring gear, and one is the capital gear, big gear is given here. So this is the torque divider systematic diagram, right? We move to the next section of this lecture. This is the MCQ section. So for this MCQ section, this is question number 1. Is the hydraulic machine for converting hydraulic power to at low pressure into a reduced volume at the higher pressure. So this is the hydraulic ram, hydraulic crane, hydraulic intensifier, and hydraulic accumulator. So for this case, hydraulic intensifier is used, and this is the correct answer for this. C answer is correct for this question. And if the diameters of the two pistons used, the arrangement are different. That is, each cylinder will vary. Hydraulic, four options is given here. First one is hydraulic velocities, hydraulic acceleration, hydraulic pressure, and hydraulic force. So the C is the right answer. The hydraulic pressure in each cylinder will vary. So move to the third question. The working volume of the intensifier is redirected by the stroke of this. Four options is given: piston, shaft, jack, and cylinder. So the correct answer for this question is here, piston. Piston is the correct answer for this question. Then move to the next cylinder. Next MCQ question. This is a intensifier are implied as a part of machines such as hydraulic press, hydraulic crane, hydraulic accumulator, and hydraulic ram. So correct answer is here, hydraulic presses. And then move to the fifth question. In hydraulic press, the metal can be crushed. The D option is right option for this case. And the next question, small intensifier usually have a in the their basic systems. So these are the steep piston case. A option is right. And then question number, move to the question number 7. Most commonly used hydraulic intensifier for a water jet cutting is this is a inline hydraulic intensifier. Here the parallel hydraulic pressed and casting hydraulic intensifier are given. So the correct answer is here, only inline hydraulic intensifier are used. So question number 8. A is a cyclic water pump that drives its power from hydroelectric sources. This is the hydraulic crane, hydraulic ram, hydraulic accumulator, and hydraulic press. So for this purpose, hydraulic ram is used here. And the question number 9. The cylinder with the smaller diameter is called the sleeve cylinder. master cylinder, working cylinder and the casting cylinder. So correct answer is here slave cylinder. A is the right option for this question. And then move to the question number 10. Okay, the main essence for the car crushing system. Four options is given here: hydraulic press, hydraulic cylinder, hydraulic pane and accumulator. So the correct answer is here hydraulic press. A option is right option for this question. Then A is right option. And then move to the references. So these are the different types of references used in this chapter. So very very thank you to all of you for the kindly listen this video. So very very thank you, and this is the last video of this lecture series. Thank you all of you.